We're here for our series on working AI, and I'm joined by James, a member of the Glean engineering team. James, can you go ahead and introduce yourself?
I'm James Simonson. I'm one of the founding engineers here at Glean, and I have been leading our efforts when it comes to connecting to all the different data sources that we support.
Thanks for coming today. So today we're talking about connectors and why not all connectors are created equal, and how we built Glean's connector framework for work AI. So when Glean was getting started, we faced a choice. We could go down a route of federated search, or we could build Google-like search with a centralized index. Which route did Glean decide to go down?
So ultimately, we decided to go down the Google route, but initially, it was very tempting to kind of consider the federated search route. All these data sources already support a search API. So if you look at Google Drive or you look at GitHub, they already have a search endpoint. You can call that, tie all those together, and then you would be done. That easy. And the problem is it just doesn't lead to a good user experience for a number of reasons. So one being that the search results are only as good as the least common denominator there. Same thing with the latency. So one might be very fast and then another might be very slow. And so you're ending up with this not very good experience. And we know coming from Google that the way you build like a really good search engine is like you have to crawl the data, you have to understand it, you have to process it, you serve it yourself. And that way you get the best of all possible worlds there. So that's the way we ultimately decided to go.
And I know that Glean has, you know, over 100 different connectors. So, you know, how did it approach kind of building this connector architecture from the ground up?
The first thing you have to recognize is just like each one of these connectors is like its own unique world. And you really have to understand what makes each one of those special. So if you look at something like, say, Slack, you've got private channels, you've got public channels, you've got DMs, you've got mentions, you've got attachments. There's just all this complexity. And that's just like one data source, right? And now you have to repeat that for all the other ones. So now how do you handle Jira? How do you handle source control like GitHub? How do you handle something like Figma where it's like mostly like a visual thing, right? So each one of these is kind of like unique, and you have to understand like what makes all of those unique and then be able to represent that in a way where you can both take advantage of your common search architecture, but then also, you know, get everything that's like unique about each one of those.
When you start to build out these connectors, what you also realize is they each have their own different permissions model. So how does Glean work within these different permissions and assure that one person doesn't accidentally get access to the salary spreadsheet at the company?
So that's one of the things that's really critical when it comes to enterprise is like you just have to respect the permission system. Like that's just fundamental to doing things in the enterprise world. And so the same way that each one is kind of unique in the way that they model their data and, you know, have different types of content, it's not just that. Each one will have the same thing when it comes to permissions too. So you might have one that uses ACLs. You might have another where it's like a file system. And so your permissions depend on which folder you're in or which shared drive you're in. There can be hierarchies of groups where it's like you need to be a member of this group, which is a member of this group, but you can't be a member of this group. And then there's things like link sharing, where not only do you have to know that there's all these links that refer to this document, but then who has seen those links so that you can grant them access to it. So it's very complicated to keep track of all that stuff. And then when anytime something changes, you have to be able to like reflect that throughout your system too, right? So it's kind of like this butterfly effect where, you know, maybe one little change happens, but then that ripples to 1,000 documents or a million documents. And so how do you get that to reflect really quickly? So we have all these different strategies that we use where we understand the permission scheme, we understand the change that's taking place, we're able to propagate that. For most situations, we can propagate that almost immediately.
When I think about all of these different connectors, you're building and designing unique ones for every single data source. How is that scalable?
So that's actually one of our secret sauces is because we've had to tackle so many different data sources across so many different customers, we're able to take those learnings from one and like apply them to all, right? So we've built this really powerful framework that drives everything, takes care of like all the common situations. So as I mentioned, there's all these kind of specific categories of data sources. So there'll be like chat data sources, email data sources, source control data sources. We can pull out kind of the common bits there. Same thing with like error handling and rate limiting and scaling, all those things. So we learn one thing in one customer and then we apply that to everybody. And these data sources though, they're not a static thing. It's not like you write one crawl and then, all right, we're done. They change over time. So just in the last week, we've seen Google Drive introduce tabs. And then we've seen Slack introduce canvases. And we've seen Zendesk introduce new permissions models. So you have to keep evolving in order to kind of stay on top of these things.
we've discussed Glean's native connectors, but we also have partner connectors as well. Can you discuss more about the larger Glean connector ecosystem?
There's a number of different ways that you can integrate with Glean, starting with just like our custom data sources, where if you just have like your own on-prem, say, ticketing system, or you have your internet portal, we can push that data into Glean, and then it can show up in the search results just like any other data source that we natively support. We also have partner-built connectors, so those will be things where companies, SaaS vendors, will already have a pre-built connector for Glean. So we have examples like Guide, Outline, who have built those. And we've been expanding into more partnerships as well. So we have a partnership with Databricks to integrate with their Genie. So there you're getting the best of both worlds, their business intelligence software combined with Glean's understanding of corporate knowledge. And then there's DataStax Langflow, where they have like a workflow engine, and then they can use Glean as one of the sources. So now you have access to all the different data sources that Glean connects to, and you can integrate those into your workflows.
So far we've talked about connectors in terms of bringing data into Glean, but there's also sending insights or triggers back. So if I think about, you know, Slack, if there's a question, how can Glean step in and answer that question? Or Jira, how can we help with IT ticket resolution back in the applications where people are already working? So can you share a little bit more about Glean Actions?
Actions is the way that you are able to push information back out from Glean. Examples of that would be summarize an outage and then generate a postmortem document and actually create that document using the information that you've collected from Glean itself. Then you're able to not just pull information into Glean, but then push it back out. And then you can build more sophisticated things. So you can automatically do all this. So we have like the Glean Assistant, which you can add to your Slack channels, and then say you have like a support channel. It can automatically answer questions. And so now you don't need a person there to do that stuff. You can have Glean just post itself. And then we've seen customers do this too. So we have like a leading mobile carrier who is using Glean to power their support portal. Support agents are able to use this single portal. They have access to all their information. Everything is integrated together so they answer questions all in one spot without having to leave their service.
Thank you so much, James, for joining me today and talking about connectors. I appreciate the time.